How do these numbers strike you?
I think Solana's doing great. If you look at the overall energy per transaction, it's, for a raw transaction, it's less than a Google search, and maybe 2 to 3, Google searches for an expensive one. It basically is as good as using a Web2 service, and I'm really proud of that.
So at this point, what further steps can be taken to reduce energy use on the Solana blockchain that you're not already doing?
Well, as the network matures and with every release it gets faster, that makes it more energy efficient, as well as every hardware release. When Intel or NVIDIA release their next generation computers, those are more energy efficient. So this will naturally get cheaper and faster and more energy efficient over time.
How big of a deal is this becoming to investors? Because you find that people who believe in Bitcoin are still relying on mining, and you see Ethereum moving over to proof of stake. And so when you're talking to investors and people who are thinking about how these blockchains work moving forward, what's going to be the driving force that pushes people into more environmental concerns?
I think this is important for a lot of applications that want to build Web2 services and attract new users, because the users really care about energy efficiency. So we see that a lot of new Web3 companies really pick Solana because of this, and really attracted to the our overall roadmap of how we're going to make the network even cheaper and faster and more reliable.
And obviously, we're a couple days away from the great merge from the Ethereum network, but what does that mean for you? Since that's happened, do you find that the competitive forces have changed by any means?
Even post-merge, Ethereum is still much less energy efficient than Solana. And I think I'm really excited about the fact that Ethereum is moving to proof of stake, because this will finally put the debate around whether proof of stake is secure to rest. I think Ethereum doing this will really make it, prove to everyone that this technology is now mature enough to handle very large, capitalization for a network.
How far could you go in terms of potentially rewarding the validators or computers that themselves use renewable energy?
This is not something that we've looked at yet, because overall the Solana network uses so little energy that it's almost insignificant amount to offset. Solana Foundation does its own offsets that covers the entire network.
So when you look more broadly, crypto obviously it obviously gets a bad rap for its energy use. Do you think that's deserved?
Well, mining is definitely very energy intensive. But folks need to understand that, Bitcoin mining would work in a world without any fossil fuels. And in the end of the day, it's the fossil fuels that are the bad part. But it's obvious to me as an engineer that we should build technologies that are more energy efficient, if they serve the same function. So I am definitely, bullish on Solana and its energy use when compared to other networks.
Other networks. If you think about also how NFTs have related to the Ethereum world versus Solana, there have been days that you're competing hard. In fact, there have been days that you see more NFTs really by dollar volumes tied to Solana, even more than Ethereum. So how do you see that competition playing out? When do you think, and do you think, you can be the more dominant player here?
Well, I want to congratulate Magic Eden, the company that's the premier marketplace on Solana, for its record-breaking volumes. So Magic Eden has had volumes bigger than, I think, all of Ethereum's NFTs combined on a couple days. That's been amazing. I think because Solana is so cheap and fast to use, that when folks experience it, they feel like they're using a regular Web2 application, and it's really hard for them to go back to using older technologies. I hope this trend continues and Magic Eden continues to grow and really accelerate NFT adoption around the world.
NFT adoption, but NFTs and actually staking itself are something that are under the eye of regulators, particularly the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission. What type of regulatory risk is there for both these, products, if you will, that are so tied to the ecosystem?
Oh, I think folks need to be careful when they look at each NFT project. I think the vast majority of them are community-based, things that are fun and build communities and brands around an idea of a shared profile. And I think those are pretty far from what most folks would consider are a security. But you still need to be careful.
Now, I have to ask you about the Ethereum merge. The Ethereum blockchain just went through this big major upgrade, and I'm curious what your thoughts are on it, and if you think it potentially makes a Solana blockchain less attractive, and how you imagine Solana staying competitive in, you know, a changed world.
Well, the Ethereum merge doesn't really improve scalability of the Ethereum network. When you look at the number of transactions that Solana handles from applications and from users on a daily basis, that's more than not just Ethereum, but all the EVM, Ethereum-based blockchains combined. So I think Ethereum has a long way to go on scalability.
Does Solana have any plans for an upgrade down the line, or how are you thinking about that?
Well, Solana is like Linux. It's a community-driven open source project. There's four teams working on the Solana core already. And every release, the network gets cheaper, faster, more reliable. So, you know, it has a roadmap like Linux, just make the next release better than the current one.